I'm Ben Iravani. I'm one of the founders of Porter's Gin. I'm also alumni of Aberdeen University. And it was there I met Josh, co-founder of Porter's.
I'm Josh, and I am a co-founder of Porter's Gin, and also an alumni of Aberdeen University.
After I graduated university, I opened a bar in Aberdeen called Orchid. And it was a few years into that that myself, Josh, and our third co-founder, Alex, turned the basement of the bar into a micro distillery, and we started to create the recipe for Porter's Gin. This year is a big year for the university with the 525th year anniversary, and having both myself and Josh been at the university and then come set up the distillery here in Aberdeen, it just seemed like a really good collaboration that we could do with the university to make a unique gin to mark this occasion. Creating the final recipe at the moment, and pretty sure it's going to be a pretty tasty little number.
We wanted to have something that really evoked kind of people's imagination when they see the product, and we wanted to tie it into the 525 years and also just the history of botany at Aberdeen University. So we worked with Mark from the Cruickshank Garden, and we picked botanicals that kind of represented each century that the university has been around.
It's a huge delight as curator of Cruickshank Botanic Garden to be associated with this project. And when I was approached, I was asked, are there plants in this temperate collection that would be suitable to help flavour gin? The immediate answer was yes. After that came the slightly more enjoyable but difficult task of narrowing down exactly which plants would be suitable.
But that flavour is going to stay with you for the rest of the day now. It's a strong flavour, and you need so little.
It was necessary to choose a plant that would represent or be appropriate in original use of the 15th century, 16th century, 17th century, moving up to today's 21st century.
Have a medicinal use particularly, say, or is it?
Of the botanic collection here across the 11 acres of Cruickshank Botanic Garden, heather is a plant that I have suggested. Nettles, dandelions, sage, pears, apples, and myrtle. And those bring us through the centuries.
We take the botanicals, either they're dried or fresh, add them to a certain type of alcohol. With us, it's 100% British wheat spirit. And we macerate them, so we leave them for a certain length of time. We then put them through our still.
We distill at low temperatures under vacuum using a kind of more scientific piece of equipment called a rotary evaporator. What this means is we can lower the boiling point of alcohol and distill at much lower temperatures than traditional stills use. That means we can capture kind of lighter, brighter, fresher flavors by not applying heat during our process.
So the alcohol is going to start to evaporate, goes up here as a gas, it's there, condenses back, cools down, so it turns back into liquid, and then in here you've got the strawberry alcohol.
The point of gin really is about taking those natural plants, so fruits, all kinds of botanicals, and taking the actual essence from those, which creates like a balanced flavour in the gin. It's actually closer to perfume making than to making whiskey, for example. I think it's going to give quite a complex flavour to the gin, but hopefully in a good way. Yeah.
It's an ongoing relationship that we've had with the university, and hopefully there's a lot more we can do in the future as well. It's been a pretty awesome journey, and we've got a great team here in Aberdeen that do some really cool, innovative stuff. So hopefully we can put that into this project as well and create something special.